Good morning. What is going on? It is May the 31st, end of the month. This has been a pretty wild month. Hopefully you had a better one than I did. Man, this was a long one. Pretty interesting trucking market we're in right now, but rates are going up, which is freaking awesome. So I wanted to go over some information with you real quick. Fuel cards and factoring. Why fuel card companies, just the fuel card companies, not the factoring companies, the fuel card companies, why fuel card companies are doing a bait and switch? What are they not telling you? I think this is pretty helpful, informative, useful information that more carriers need to be made aware of, because there is a bait and switch misrepresentation that's going on right now within the industry. That it just blows me away. You know, it's kind of like with anything. You know, I work in trucking. My dad, I'm actually at his house in San Antonio this weekend for Memorial Weekend. 62 years old, had a birthday party for him. It's a lot of fun. Worked on the ranch a little bit, fixing fences. Didn't break anything, which was good. But anyway, you know, he's in the banking game. I'm in the freight game. And, you know, when you work with a variety of different businesses, let's just take, for example, like Jimmy John's. I don't know anything about a Jimmy John's franchise. I don't know anything about that. So if I was to go interview with someone to inquire about purchasing a Jimmy John franchise, I don't really know the right questions to ask about hospitality and food and beverage service. That's not my niche. That's not my industry. I don't really know the appropriate questions to ask. I'm new to that business. I don't know anything about it. I don't know the right questions to ask. So I'm bringing that up pertaining to you. You're new to trucking. You don't know the right questions to ask, and that's okay because you're new. You're not supposed to know. And because of that, unfortunately, not everybody plays fairly in the sandbox. And what I mean by that is people do a bait and switch, and they don't reveal both sides of the story. Part of the joy and, you know, I love what I do. The love of what I do is to help carriers like you that are brand new to the game be as well informed as possible, taking my experience from being a broker, being a factor, helping hundreds of carriers getting going in this business and have been on the street more or less, learning the good, the bad, and the ugly, and being able to communicate to you, hey, these are things to avoid. These are speed bumps. This is a way to get a better head start to get the business off the ground and running. And if I'm able to give you data, information, you know, stuff that you can learn from to make better decisions to help grow the business, well, then that's what I'm here to do. And the business will be healthier, stronger, and you'll earn more. And that's awesome. That's the goal. So let's dive into some misrepresentation that's taking place with the fuel cards, and they're not disclosing everything to you. So what I mean by that is, let's get over here, and all right, changes the slide. So a bait and switch scam, over-promising and under-delivering, right? So what these fuel card companies are doing, and I'm seeing this more right now than ever before, 50% of the time I can fix it, 50% of the time I can't. And I'll get into that a little bit later. But what these fuel card companies are doing is they're going to call you up, just kind of like I called you, or maybe somebody referred you to me. Anyway, they're going to call you up and say, hey, you know, I got the best fuel card. I got the best fuel card on planet Earth. You need it. I'd like to send it to you in the mail. And you'll be like, sure, whatever. I need a fuel card. I'm going to have three drivers. They're going to need a fuel card. Send me the fuel card. And you get it in the mail. Cool. And that's all you talked about was a fuel card. Well, you get it. 2 days later, you call me. 2 weeks later, you call me and say, Paul, it's time to get set up with factoring. Let's do it. Let's get set up. And I'm like, okay, cool. I send you over the application. It takes 60 seconds for you to fill in the blanks. It takes me 24 hours to set you up, typically on average, for 90% of the people that I work with. And that's the process. But I'm going to have to call you and be like, hey, I can't sign you up for freight factoring because that fuel card company, the one that called you, the one that sent you that fuel card in the mail, unfortunately, they also signed you up for freight factoring and didn't even disclose that with you. Without your authorization, without your approval, I'm not joking when I say that. This is not a joke. Without your personal authorization and approval, they sign you up for factoring and you don't even know it. You thought you were just getting a fuel card. No, no, no. They've also signed you up for factoring. They've signed you up for factoring at 4.5% for 18 months and a $5,000 cancellation fee. They literally are putting you in a headlock and trying to stick your shoes in concrete and forcing you to work with them. That is the bait and switch. It's the cheese. The cheese is, oh, here's a fuel card. It's the best one out there. The fuel cards, they're kind of a dime a dozen. There's a whole bunch of companies out there that do fuel cards, a whole bunch of them. They all kind of do the same thing. However, some of the beauty of me working in this business, here's a better representation, you know, fuel cards, whatever. Part of the beauty about me being in this business is I network people everywhere, all across the United States. I probably have worked with over 200 carriers doing this, what I do, freight factoring. And I learn a lot. I see a lot. Carriers call me, ask me questions, ask for help, helping them troubleshoot and fix problems and scenarios that I've experienced being on the brokerage side of the business and trying to help them on the carrier side of the business and just helping juggling these elephants and keeping everything in motion. And it's awesome. I love my job. I love my job. I'm very, very, very blessed. And I would say that should be a positive sign for somebody like you to work with me. You know, I'd rather be working with somebody that's been in the game for a long time and enjoys what they do as opposed to working with somebody that isn't enthusiastic, isn't helpful, isn't encouraging, isn't positive or optimistic, and they hate their job. Well, I'm probably going to work with a person that likes what they do because they're passionate about it. And that's why I make these videos. That's why I built the website. And two, I'm going to actually link at the bottom a link to the blog that I have about fuel cards in even more detail, and you can read that too down below. But anyway, I get to learn the good, the bad, the ugly, talking with all these carriers all over the United States. And I have one carrier that I've been working with. His name is Keith, KTM Enterprises, and he is out in Philadelphia. And he's been rocking with me for about 3 years. And I've learned a lot from Keith, and Keith has learned a lot from me. It's been a great partnership. And great friendship. Every time he comes into town, for the most part, I missed him last time he came into town when I was living in Charleston. That was annoying. I wish I could have met him, could have seen him. But we'll go to Crackle Barrel, we'll meet up, and he's a different state. He'll call me up, hey, Paul, I'm in town, let's get some food. And if he's within, you know, an hour away, we'll meet up at, you know, Mexican restaurant, hole-in-the-wall bar. Same thing with you. If you're local, you're running around the corner, or you're going to be passing through, hit me up, and I'll buy you a burger, I'll buy you a steak. But anyway, I'm rambling. Sorry about that. Again, I love what I do. I love the people that I work with. I really enjoy it. But fuel cards. Working with Keith, Keith actually has found a fuel card that has saved him over $10,000 a year in fuel cost. Insurance and fuel. Those are your two biggest expenses in this trucking business. And, you know, G-Squared Funding, we have our own fuel card. But if I know something better, why am I not going to recommend what's better? Why would I not do that? So I don't care. I want you to have the best tools and the best information to be as successful as possible. It's a no-brainer. So that's the fuel card that I recommend to everybody. I don't give it out willy-nilly. I just don't tell people about it. You got to work with me for me to tell you about that fuel card. That is a huge perk. But for the most part, a lot of these fuel cards, they're just a dime a dozen. A lot of them just, oh, this benefit, that benefit, X, Y, Z. I have found something that is very different than the rest. And, that's what I recommend to guys to use when they get going. Same thing too, you know, to elaborate a little bit about Keith, you know, I guess, well, maybe I'll make that in another video in regards to, you know, getting paid on loads by brokers. When you go outside of factoring, which you can do factoring, which is the quickest, broker quick pay, which is the second quickest, we can take 4 to 7 days. Factoring is the same day deposit, and then you can wait, you know, 30 days, 90 days to get a check in the mail. And we can go over that in a different video. But Keith, awesome dude, he learns from me, I learn from him, and trying to help you learn from me right now. So what happens is you're stuck between a rock and a hard spot when you sign up for these fuel card companies and they don't disclose that you have also signed up for freight factoring and you're stuck with them. Sometimes I'm able to help carriers break away from these people that have bait and switched them. Sometimes I can't. But it really comes down to stuck between a rock and a hard spot, and they will put you in a headlock and they'll force you to work with them. Nobody wants to work with anybody that's forced to work with somebody else. Like, why would you want that? Big joy that I find with me is, I work with people that I want to work with. They work with me if they want to work with me. And I even had a guy this past week. He was just a schmuck. And I don't work for a company where we're like, oh, you're desperate. You gotta sign people up for factoring all the time. No. I had a guy probably 2 months ago that had four box trucks. He just loose cannon, rude, disrespectful. Didn't listen. It's like, nah, I'm good, man. I'll recommend you go work with somebody else. I don't want to work with you. I turn people away all the time. Even this past week, there was another gentleman. He has a box truck, and it's like, hey, man, I just don't think this is a good fit. I don't think this is a good fit. And I say that obviously respectfully and politely, but just a loose cannon. This guy's gonna be more trouble than a positive. He's gonna be more of a negative. And I'm just like, nah. So I'm not that kind of guy. So disclosing that, but that's me, and I play fairly in the sandbox. A lot of these companies don't, and that was the point of this video. 50% probability if this happens to you, 50% probability you're stuck. So that's why I recommend when you get a fuel card, that'd be the last thing to do on your to-do list, the very last thing. Get running with your truck over the road with a credit card, cashback credit card, for anywhere between 1 week to 15 days to 30 days. Figure out the pieces of the puzzle. You don't need to sign up for a fuel card immediately. And when you do need the fuel card, call me because I know the best one out there. I did want to make a quick notation with a carrier that I have been working with, Darren, and he worked with me. And I wanted to sort of circle, actually, both of these are positive reviews about me. But the one circled, it says, it was a pleasure. I was very pleased with Paul. He was very professional and thorough, and he was able to get my contract done. Contract, I don't like that word. It is a contract, but my contracts are 30-day contracts. Don't tell anybody. Don't tell anybody. Hopefully, he didn't even pick up the audio. So I do this very differently than everybody else. And in spite of unexpected challenges, what he's pertaining to in this right here is he was a carrier that signed up for a fuel card, and they also signed him up for factoring without disclosing that to him. And it took about 2 weeks delaying the business and him getting off that starting line to get going and start moving loads. So it put him behind the eight ball by 2 weeks. And we were able to fix it, but it wasn't pretty. It was probably 25 emails going back and forth, chewing these people out, telling them, you have no authorization to do this. And yet they did do it, and they signed him up, and it wasn't his approval to do it. Anyway, so long story short, I don't want to turn this into too much of a ranting video, but this is information that I think you should be very informed about, and it needs to be brought to your attention. And it's not just talking to a fuel card person on the phone and saying, yes, send me the fuel card. It's talking to them on the phone and you not saying yes. And you didn't even say yes, and yet they've signed you up for it, and they didn't even mail you the fuel card. That happens to people too. So anyway, hopefully you take this as positive 2 cents. This is outstanding advice. I wish more people would listen and understand and grasp onto this. Not everybody does. So I hope you enjoyed the video. Hope this will help you make better decisions in the future. Call me and I'll get you set up for factoring and introduce you to my freight network. And let's play the freight game. Hope you have a great day. Catch you on the next video. Bye.